A special thanks to my sponsors listed above. If you have not given them a follow, go check them out on Facebook or Instagram. They are great people and they're for the sportsman. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Spars Outdoors, and we're going to start right off with the fishing report for the week. Let's go right down to Lake St. Clair. Down there in all the canals, all the cuts, lots of bass, some big crappies going on, bluegills, stuff like that. Weeds are starting to grow up. It's a great time to fish. My buddy actually caught some of the biggest largemouth I've seen all year, except for a few that we caught underneath the ice. So that's going on down there on Lake St. Clair. I don't know much about the musky fish, and I heard they're starting to get a few trolling out on Lake St. Clair. I don't get too much into the Lake St. Clair because I fish the St. Clair River and Lake Huron a lot. So Lake St. Clair is more of my ice fishing time of year and just after ice and before ice comes. That's when I like to go down to Lake St. Clair. So let's just head right down to the Algonac Marine City area. Walleye fishing is doing great. It's not where it's going to be. It's not full potential, but it's really picking up pretty quick. It's doing very good. Whipping, casting from shore, hand lining, all good tactics to catch those fish. Come right down to the St. Clair area, and they're still getting cohos trolling around right down there by the DTE and picking up walleyes, jigging all through there. St. Clair Marine City, really good if you know the spots to jig, very good for jigging. I watch multiple boats getting fish, pulling fish after fish. So that's going on right now. Let's head up here a little bit closer to home here in Marysville, all the way down to the Blue Water Bridge area, so Port Huron area. Same thing, whipping's picking up. Jigging on the Canadian side is a little bit better than the American side, but they're still picking up fish jigging on the American side. Doing great. Still getting some cohos, stuff like that. Fishing from shore, casting's really picked up, doing very well all along shore. Jigging from shore is doing good. It's going to get better, you know, but it is a good time to fish. They're getting lots of fish, lots of walleyes right now. So get out there and get casting, you will catch fish. If you got a boat, get out whipping, you will catch fish. Go jigging, you will catch fish. Pick up the occasional coho, Atlantic, stuff like that. Now let's get right into the boardwalk fishing. Walleyes are starting to pick up a little bit better on the river rods at nighttime. Using the small, like F9 Rapalas. I recommend you getting some of the John Latham Custom Rapalas, obviously, for that. Challengers, red-eye spoons are picking up walleyes. They're getting a few lake trout here and there, a few cohos, a couple steelhead, and then, you know, just your typical this time of year type of thing going on right now. You're going to pick up a little bit of everything, but you're going to get your walleyes more towards dark and after dark. So, great time to get down fishing. It's going to get better and better and better as we warm up here. I know we got a rainy weekend ahead of us, so that should ramp things up as well. Now let's just head right up into Lake Huron out there trolling for those cohos. There's still a few spring kings being caught. You know, I lost one at the back of the boat, got some nice cohos, a couple lakers, doing great. Now the fish have moved out a little bit deeper. We're getting fish in the 30 or 45 foot of water, even out in 60 foot of water. And that's right here in Lexington and Port Sanilac area. Head a little farther up to Harbor Beach. That 15 to 40 foot of water is doing great. I haven't heard of people getting fish into 8 and 9 foot of water. So you can try that as well if you like to fish in shallow. It never hurts to run in shallow. Start shallow, go deep. You know, that's what I always do. I just start off wherever I stop my boat and I start trolling out. I'll zigzag in and out until I find a pot of fish. So it's a great bite. Head a little bit farther north, up into the Kaysville area. Trolling out of there, you got to go a little bit deeper, 60, 70 foot of water. They're getting lots of lake trout, tons of them. So if you like to catch lake trout, that's the place to go. Go trolling, troll slow, 1.8 to 2.2. That's your typical trolling speeds for your lake trout. I mean, you get them at 2.4 and 2.5, 2.6, even up to 3 mile an hour. Everybody that trolls knows that. But when you're trolling for lake trout, run everything low. And run slow. That's just how you do it for the lake trout. They're getting some cohos up there. So if I was to go up there, I would troll like 2.3, so I'd get a little bit of everything. And also I wanted to bring up the walleyes and the whole lake trolling out there for salmon. The walleyes you're getting right now are nice. It's not like the summer when you'll get a whole bunch of walleyes, you know, but you are getting a few mixed in, so it makes for a nice box of fish when you go out trolling. Things slowed down there for a couple days after that tournament, but then they fired right back up. You just got to go to know. One day you can go out there and get nothing. Next day you can go out there and fill your box. So it's a great fishery. It's a great place to fish. Now let's head up into Sebwing. I never did get a perch report, so I don't know what's going on. I know there's still to come. I'm just waiting for Les Alexander at Alexander's Bait and Tackle to let me know, and I'll let you guys know when it's time to go up there for them perch. Usually it's already happened. For some reason it has not. This weather has everything messed up. A lot of bluegill, a lot of bass, a lot of pike action going on up in there right now. They're still getting a few crappies, but they even slowed down, which is really weird. Now, that we got that main river system out of the way, let's come back into the port here and head up to Black River, okay? They're getting steelhead out by Ford's Dam there in Mill Creek. A lot of steelhead are going through there right now. There's a lot of sucker fishing going on right there by the old Iron Bridge off 136. All through Mill Creek and Black River, sucker fishing is phenomenal right now. You know, there's your local marinas, they're holding crappies. You got to have permission to go in there because they're writing tickets and they're writing them rapidly this year. So they're towing boats. If you did not pay for a well, don't park your boat in there because they are going to tow you out of there. But some of the other marinas you can get in there. You can access these from boats. You can catch fish. You can get some crappies right now. I know you can. The water's still dirty. It's never really got cleaned up enough yet. That water temperature is still cold. Give it another 2 weeks and the crappies should really start taking off. Pike and muskie loaded. Black River is loaded with pike right now. I can't say so much on the muskie. There's a few being caught, but the pike fishing is phenomenal right now. I've never seen so many pike be caught this time of year in Black River. I mean, tons. You know, they're spawning right now and they're on a feed. They're real aggressive when they spawn. So pike are fun to catch. If you'd like to catch pike, all the off branches on Black River, just like you would fish your crappies around all the structure, you're going to get a lot of pike casting around that same structure you would those panfish. So Black River is a hot spot to fish right now, and I'm sure it would be the same in Pine River and Bell River and Clinton River and all that. As you head back south, you could do the same thing up in there. I know that they're getting a lot of suckers in Clinton River right now and some steelhead, and I know they're getting a lot of suckers right now in Bell River and Pine River as well. So it's a fun time. Take some time out of your weekend if you ain't doing nothing and go catch some suckers. It makes for a great family day to catch some fish and have some fun. So last week I did my fishing report live. If you didn't see that, I'm sorry. I did it live with a giveaway. It was you can check the live feed and you can see it. So, but that's about all I got for you for the fishing report for this week. So get out there, get fishing. Good luck and just enjoy this time and get some walleyes and fill that freezer up, guys. Thanks everybody again for watching Spars Outdoors.